Fresh from the showcase here at Swiss Watch Expo, and I have a new arrival here for all the Speedmaster and Moonwatch bands out here. I have got an Omega Speedmaster Special Edition, the first Omega in space, and this one is in a beautiful rose, or what they call Sedna gold. And this is a stunning watch with a fascinating history and really an excellent commemoration for Omega's relationship with NASA and space, like so many of these beautiful Speedmasters are. The story behind this one, actually, in 1962 for the Sigma 7 mission, astronaut Wally Schirra actually bought an Omega Speedmaster for his own personal use and then was later picked to join space in that mission, which I didn't know. I don't know if any of you space fans are out there. I had no idea that astronauts just got to take their own stuff into the great beyond. So that's interesting for any of you aspiring cosmonauts out there. You don't even have to say goodbye to your stuff. So this actually predates Omega's official relationship with NASA. That was specifically for the Apollo mission and to go to the moon. This predated that by several years and was just Wally Schirra's personal watch. So that already sort of an interesting sort of heritage with space travel that even predated NASA choosing the Speedmaster to be the official watch of the Apollo missions. That original watch was not in rose gold. This is to commemorate that watch. And this is a beautiful Omega with a couple of things that make it similar to the moon watches you probably know and love, and a few striking differences as well. One of the most striking differences, other than obviously the rose gold case, is the case size is 39.7 millimeters, which is noticeably smaller and a little dressier than the traditional moon watch at 42 millimeters. This does still have the 1861 movement that all of them do. And this one, of course, has a beautiful panda dial. The subdials and ring around it are actually a very deep, dark brown, not a black like you might see in a lot of other panda dials. So that makes this very unique as well. Also, instead of the hazelite crystal, this has a sapphire crystal and a ceramic bezel insert. So this will be much, much more durable than most moonwatches and really most other Speedmasters you might see, which is interesting considering how dressy this is. This also has an absolutely beautiful original Omega brown leather strap, which is absolutely stunning pattern, stunning shape to the leather, and of course, a beautiful contrast you get with this white stitching. If you turn around to the back, you do have a patterned, the Omega emblem. Again, this predates any and all NASA mission patches. So there wouldn't be anything signifying the mission because NASA didn't even do that in 62 when they launched old Wally Schirra into the great unknown. On the back, it does say the first Omega in space and, of course, the date of the mission, which was October 3rd, 1962. This is a stunning watch. Another quick difference you're going to notice is the hands are actually not the straight hands that you might notice on the moon watch that I'm wearing. This actually has what some call the arrow, or what some people refer to as leaf hands, which are a little more triangular, and does really interesting when you see this glow in the dark, because you'll notice the Bennett hand here has the absolute thinnest line of lume I think I've ever seen on any sort of chronograph watch. And when you see this, it is just the faintest green glow that you will see when this glows in the dark. One of the many things that's beautiful about this watch, it is a lot more petite and dressy on the wrist than most Speedmasters you might be used to, other than perhaps the reduced. But the rose gold of the case does make it a lot heftier. Will this be your first moon watch, your first Speedmaster, your first chronograph? Almost certainly not. But if you're a big fan of the Speedmaster, if you're looking to add to your chronograph collection with something dressy, something interesting, something with a rich heritage, and something specifically in rose gold, I really don't think you can do any better than this. It's absolutely beautiful. It retailed for $18,000 when it released. We have this listed for much, much less than that, and it is in absolute mint condition, including this strap, which really doesn't look like it spent any time on the wrist at all. If you're interested in a rose gold chronograph, give us a call. Send us an email. Let us know. If this watch is still available, we'd love to send it to you, but I don't think it's going to be around very long. And, of course, as always, like and subscribe. Hit the notification bell so you'll know when the next video drops. And, of course, just give us a call at SwissWatchExpo.com.